The series examines how technology has transformed how people around the world interact with money, highlighting purpose-driven innovation from the FinTech community. We'll be hearing some of those stories firsthand. So to tell us more and to welcome our panel, delighted to now welcome to the stage the Director of Marketing and Communications at Innovate Finance, Roberto Napolitano. Baby, I don't need dollar bills to have fun tonight.
Good morning. Welcome to this fantastic panel. I'm very excited to have with me today a fantastic panel. What can I say? So I've got Claire Small, executive producer at BBC StoryWorks. I got Ingrid, Anusic, marketing director at Moneyhub. Travers, Clarke-Walker, chief marketing officer at Thought Machine. Welcome, Travers. Anil, Noonan, corporate strategy and development at Paysend. And Ellen Anderson, VP of Marketing at Unison. Thank you very much all for coming today. So a quick introduction about the BBC and Innovate Finance StoryWorks series. We're very delighted, very excited to launch this second original series called Wired Differently, Innovation in Finance, produced by the amazing team at the BBC StoryWorks commercial production, and is launching today at IFGS. So the series really meets the innovators who are wired differently and are shaping the world of finance to change lives, to change financial lives, and to help organizations and consumers improve their financial lives. The series will launch on the bbc.com website as well this month, and if you have questions or if you want to learn more about this initiative, you can visit the dedicated hub site, innovatefinance.com, Wired Differently series. You can also follow on social with hashtag IFGS2023 and also hashtag Wired Differently. So without further ado, Claire, let's start with you. Okay. So I've got a bit of bio, which is, you know, impressive bio from Claire. So Claire, actually, she's an award-winning executive producer who started a career at the BBC Northern Ireland. She has produced and directed numerous successful television series for international broadcasters. That's quite impressive, Claire.
Thank you.
So let's start with the question, why did we go with the name Wired Differently, and what was the objective of the second series?
Okay. So with Wired Differently, we wanted to show the innovation and the ecosystem within fintechs in the UK and beyond. The idea of looking at how these companies are disrupting traditional systems and traditional finance systems. So for us, we thought the people involved, the people who think about these things, the people who want to make changes are wired differently. They view it different to the rest of maybe the financial structure that had been there for a very long time. So that was our main aim for the Wired Differently. We had series one, which launched in April 2020. And we had such a brilliant success with that. I think we had 4 million video views, 6 million social media views or engagements, and within our department, and we make a lot of films, 6 out of 10 of our best performing films of all time came from series one. So we have a very hard but high bar for series two.
Yes.
Yeah.
No pressure. But,
no pressure at all.
I'm sure it's going to be a great success.
Yeah.
So thank you very much, Claire. I'd like to introduce now Ingrid. Ingrid Anusic, Marketing Director at Moneyhub. Ingrid is a growth marketer with deep experience in helping fintech scale. Named as one of the top 30 most influential fintech marketeers by the FinTech Marketing Hub and a rising star 2022 at the UK FinTech Awards. Welcome to stage, Ingrid. Before we ask you the first question, shall we maybe share with everyone the short video clip from Moneyhub and BBC StoryWorks?
Just like in the creation of music where it's rhythmical and it repeats over and over and that's what makes it good, finance is also, you know, rhythmic. And just like a song falls apart when you lose rhythm, your finances fall apart when you lose rhythm.
The technology enables you to bring everything together in one place. Not just your bank balances, your credit card, but your investments, your pensions.
And just like that, I was able to find out exactly where money was going and how I was spending it. It's being able to get on with more of the stuff that you enjoy and less of the stuff that you don't, while still remaining in control.
Excellent, thank you very much. Musicians and financial services, what a great combination. Can you tell us more about Moneyhub, and also what was your expectation in taking part to this series?
Yes, Moneyhub is a data and payments company built on the principle of open finance and open banking. And our mission is to really help people be better off by ensuring the financial health is in order. And we do that by automating money management. But at the same time, we also work with businesses so they understand their customers better in order to deliver them better, more relevant and appropriate products. And this is all based around the data we can provide. And
the second question was, what was your expectation in taking part to the series?
Yes, I mean, first of all, we've been members with Innovate Finance for several years, which was very, very much part of our growth success as well. But also having seen that this came from, this cooperation is with the BBC, we just knew we were going to have a lovely, lovely video coming out of this partnership. But most importantly, the purpose of this campaign is really very much aligned with our own mission of helping people and showing how tech can help. So that was absolutely crucial for us. And what we're hoping to get out today is really sending and delivering the message is that technology is here today for businesses and consumers to benefit from data.
Excellent, thank you very much. And then Claire, from a storytelling perspective, what was the kind of the main challenge in producing this documentary with Moneyhub?
We were talking about this earlier on. Actually, with Moneyhub, they obviously are a B2B company, but also we had this discussion on whether there's such a thing as B2B or B2C. To me, everybody's B2C. So it was trying to hit the right tone in terms of making sure that we got the key messages that you wanted to discuss, but also making sure it was interesting for an average person to look at. As you mentioned, musicians and FinTech don't necessarily go together, but that was the pleasure of making this film in particular, because we got to see somebody who was probably the complete other end of the spectrum in terms of career choice from FinTech, but he needs it, and we can see how it helps him function.
Great, thank you very much. Let me introduce you to Travers from Thought Machine. So Travers heads up Thought Machine's marketing team and is responsible for leading brand building activities to drive global growth. Travers has made more than 15 years board level experience scaling regional sales and marketing functions across software, banking, energy and retail industries. And before joining Thought Machine, Travers was chief marketing officer at Fiserv and managing director at Barclays, where he led the market launch of peer-to-peer payment app Pingit. And prior to that, Travers was responsible for launching EDF Energy into the UK, as well as building the pioneering Nectar scheme. What an impressive bio, Travers.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, everyone. So let's show now Thought Machine's video clip.
Okay. Technology has changed so much over the decades. Nearly all technology that everybody uses or experiences today runs in the cloud. Banks are one of the few exceptions that don't. Most states' mainframe computers, which are large static computers built in the pre-internet era, we expect thousands of banks to move to the cloud in the next few years, and it's going to be very difficult for them if they don't.
Excellent, thank you very much. So, Travers, first of all, great video. Very excited to see the full one. When you joined this series, what was the key message that you wanted to deliver through the Wired Differently series this time?
Thank you, Roberto. I mean, to some extent, it's almost in the title, Wired Differently. And as we heard in the video there, the technology that sits within banks today is antiquated, referenced in a whole variety of different ways, legacy, previous generation, and so on. Thought Machine as a company has set itself out to be the foundations of modern banking with new generation technology. Notably through two products. First product is Vault Core, which is a next generation core banking platform, and more recently introduced Vault Payments, which is a next generation payments platform. So as we said in the film, we expect banks to adopt a new generation of technology, or more to the point, if banks don't adopt a new generation of technology, particularly at their core and payment systems, they will be left behind. And historically, banks have been at the vanguard of technological renewal, mm-hmm. and they're kind of falling behind at the moment. And we've set ourselves out to bring a technology that solves for that. In terms of participating in the film, high quality storytelling that brings resonance to that message and brings it to a wide audience is an important part of it. We can believe that we only want to talk to very specific technologists in banks, but the reality is everybody within the financial services industry needs to be aware that the underlying technology in banks is antiquated, it's decaying, it's monolithically coded, it's sitting on previous generations of infrastructure, and if we do not take responsibility as an industry to renew that, then the industry sets itself out to fail its end consumers, kind of to the B2B, yeah. B2C point. And if we fail those consumers, then we fail the global economic positions as well. So that was some of our expectation. And it's interesting to try and tell a story which is highly technical and kind of a mass market style methodology.
Yes, that's actually a very good point. And I'd like to bring back Claire for this. So how do you actually translate a kind of complex concept like that of Thought Machine into an easy to understand concept for the broader audience?
It was a challenge, to be honest, but a really fun challenge. Obviously, cloud banking, for a start, not many people know what it is. And secondly, how do you visualize that? So I always think challenges actually create more creativity and often places, which probably aligns with a lot of innovation in fintech. But we had a look and we worked really closely with the team to look at ways that we could visualize it through visual metaphors and things, points that people would understand. I'm Gen X, so I love to use the analog phone right through to the digital, so I don't know how many younger people will get those references, but to put it in a context that we all use phones, we've all seen how they've changed, so therefore we can understand the wider, well, to a certain extent, the wider complexities of cloud banking. So that was it.
Excellent. Thank you very much. I'm very happy to have on stage kind of marketing leaders. So it's all marketeers except maybe Anil, and that's the next person I'm going to introduce. It's okay, but yes.
Imposter.
So Anil Noonan, corporate strategy and development at Paysend, is responsible for leading corporate strategy and development activities alongside Paysend's founders, chief financial officer, and chief strategy officer. This includes fundraising, board and investor relations, M&A, and group strategy. Paysend is a unique global payments platform for consumers, businesses, and enterprises to pay and send instantly, anywhere, anyhow, and in any currency. Formed in 2017, Paysend became the first platform to build interoperability between the three biggest card networks, Visa, MasterCard, and UnionPay. And now the firm has over 7 million customers, has raised over $150 million in funding, and has hubs in London, Miami, Singapore, and Belgrade. Welcome to the stage, Anil.
Thank you.
And let me just show the video clip from Paysend.
Tenemos tantos años de no vernos, ya nos abrazarnos y vernos. Mi hermano Miguel Ángel tuvo que ir a Estados Unidos.
Latino immigrants are a lifeline to their loved ones back at home. Via Paysend Libre, people will be able to send remittances in a more simple, faster, and in a lower cost way.
Excellent, thank you very much. When I watched this video clip, I was quite inspired because it's telling me like this is all about financial inclusion and making lives, everybody's lives better financially. And so the question to me, to you was that the expectation when you joined the series? Like that was the message that you wanted to deliver to a broader audience?
Yeah, so with Paysend Libre, what we were really trying to convey was the human impact of financial inclusion. So beyond the commercial implications on an individual's level, what's the actual impact of them on a daily basis. So what the film is really about is a product called Libre, which in essence is a mechanism for a user to receive a remittance digitally via text message. So they click on the link within the text and that takes them to the Paysend app. The funds are then preloaded onto a virtually issued instantly virtually issued MasterCard, and the user then can benefit from the fact that the remittance is faster, simpler, and at lower cost than traditional incumbent methods. But more so than that, once the user has this virtual card, they're included in the financial system, so they can actually go and use the card POS in store, online, or even withdraw cash as they would normally from an ATM. So the real power of storytelling, as kind of Travers mentioned, kind of comes through with the human examples, which I hope we've been able to portray in the film. And so, yeah.
Yeah, that was great, actually. And Claire, this is a very, very inspiring story.
Yeah.
Can you tell us more about the production of this video? Also, from a logistic perspective, because I think you you produced this video in which country?
Guatemala.
Yeah.
I think it's a key element because it's financial inclusion, which is obviously a key element of our series. So when we tackle something like this, we obviously want to look at representation and make sure it's appropriate and it's true and it's fair. For Miguel, I always say this, it's a privilege that these people allow us into their life. Even if it's only for a short 5-minute film, they still let us see them, meet their family, and show what their challenges are and the wider societal challenges. So with Miguel, obviously, he is from a lower socioeconomic background, so we had to make sure that we made him, conveyed his story, but obviously conveyed hope within his story and made sure we were truthful and we represented it properly. I think it comes back to good storytelling, to Anil's point. He was front and center of that story. His family was front and center, and that's what makes it so emotive and believable.
Yes, and very kind of concrete. You can feel it, like, okay, this is how FinTech are actually helping people around the world, making their lives better. Yeah. So that was very inspiring, so thank you very much for that. So next in the panel is Helene Anderson, VP of Marketing at Unison. Welcome, Helene, on stage. So Helene is a global marketing and product executive with over 20 years of experience helping B2B, SaaS, and cloud business models, cybersecurity, retail, and fintech companies drive marketing results, growth, and market shares. Helene is currently the VP of Marketing at Unison. I believe it's a San Francisco-based organization, a fintech organization dedicated to helping homeowners access equity they already own without interest, debt, or monthly payments. And prior to Unison, Helene was leading marketing comms and product marketing for many brands such as McAfee, SoftBank, American Power Conversion, and AutoZone. Welcome on stage, Helene. Let's show this fantastic video clip from Unison.
Thank you, Roberto.
The reality in America specifically is that there is up to $30 trillion of equity locked in homeowners' homes. It's a lot of money. That's things they can do for retirement. They can put their kids through college. They can start a business. There's all kinds of things that you can do, and unlocking that is huge. Historically, homeowners have only really had one option to tap into that, and that's mortgage. And that's fine for a lot of people, but we're working with normal people, normal Americans, right? They need more options.
Excellent. Thank you very much. So Helene, tell us more about the concept behind Unison. It's a very interesting concept. And then, again, the question, what's your expectation in terms of taking part to this initiative?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, will you hear me? Sorry. So Unison, as you mentioned, we are based out of San Francisco. We also opened an office in Omaha, Nebraska, a couple years ago, actually just a year ago. So the concept of Unison is very simple. We help homeowners to unlock their equity from their home, and then they can leverage that money to do anything they want. They can, like you see, send their kids to college, they can pay out debt, they can retire very comfortably, and you know, there's so many use cases, so many good stories. And so how do we do that? It's not a loan. So there's no monthly payment, there's no interest. We enter in a really partnership with our homeowners for 30 years. And what we do is they get the lump sum money at the agreement, and then at the end of the agreement, whether it's 30 years or sooner, they will pay back that lump sum of money plus a percentage of the increased value. So let's say today your home is 500,000 or 500,000 pounds or euros, and if it gains equity
let's say, 200,000 pounds, we take a percentage of that increased value. So with 30 years, the home has the ability to increase its value, and then that's how we help our homeowners. And we've done that for over 10,000 homeowners so far. So it's a really great way for them to, you know, unlock equity of their homes.
That's a great, great business model. And is it based just in the US? Is that your primary market, or are you looking to?
So right now it is in the US. We're trying to get the concept proven in the US. We operate in 30 states as of today. There's a possibility that we will grow overseas. It's a little premature to talk about it yet. But as you know, homes increase value everywhere in the world. If you know, homeowners don't have to get into debt to have access to money for big purchases or paying out debt, or like the Katia family, then you know, it's a great option for them.
Excellent, thank you. And when you joined the Wired Differently series, what was the key message that you want to deliver through the video, through the documentary?
You know, I think it's such a new industry for us. We really try to disrupt the way people are accessing to funding. So I think our main purpose here is to evangelize the concept for homeowners, for future homeowners. But it's also a great opportunity for investors that they, traditionally investors have been looking into commercial real estate. Mm-hmm. And this industry represents 30 trillion. It's not a small, you know, market. So there's a lot of opportunities for them. So that's what we're hoping to do.
Great, thank you very much. And Claire, can I bring you into this conversation? So. This is really about making sure that people can enjoy their lives with the equity they have, and so improve financial wellness for people. Was that the angle that you used for this documentary, specifically for Unison?
Yes, we looked at equity sharing. is a difficult concept to understand. So firstly, we looked at how we could convey that in a way that was simple enough for people to grasp, but obviously giving them all the information they needed. Yes. For us, it was really important for the series, and in particular for this film, to look at multi-generational concepts. You know, we all are heading toward retirement at one day, so we all want to think that we're going to be okay in our retirement. Our Isan, who's our main person within the film, he through his journey, we see the experience of him being able to have a better life because he's been able to like release some equity. So I think it's really important. It also shows that fintech is not just per se for millennials or Gen Z. It impacts every aspect of society. And and also financial wellness, which is another massive subject that we wanted to tackle with the series, was so important. And I think you can see from this, but you can see in the longer film that you all need to go and watch, that Isan really does have a lot better lifestyle because of the equity that's been released for him.
It's very, very good human stories, actually.
Yeah.
So you can actually see people's lives changing and improving.
Exactly.
And this is all about, you know, financial inclusion, financial wellness. This is really our goal for this series, right? Yeah. To really depict financial inclusion, financial wellness, and how fintechs are helping consumers and businesses around the globe, right? And very excited to see the 10 videos that are going to be released soon. And you know, there's this hub site that I welcome everybody to have a look. Innovatefinance.com, Wired Differently series. Now, the second question that I have, maybe let's start with you, Claire, is about success, right? So you're all kind of marketeers. You understand the value of branding and, you know, video marketing and so on. So how do we measure success in terms of the initiative from a marketing standpoint?
I think we can measure it in two ways. There's obviously the data. So we have multiple systems that will track how the films are playing across social on the hub site. We've got the dedicated hub site also on bbc.com, which is available to the wider world, unfortunately not in the UK. And so we'll look at the data and we'll keep a close eye on that. But for us and for the team that worked on it within the BBC, I think our success is that people learn something and we start conversations, and people who normally wouldn't be interested in finance can actually access it in a way that it's palatable for them, so they get it. So that would be our, I would say, engagements. If I was to really put it down, I want to see the engagements across social media. So
yes. Thank you very much. Now, moving quickly to Ingrid, what does success look like for Moneyhub, specifically for this series?
Going back to the people factor, it's really helping as many people as we can and to be better off. And for us, really, it is that we can only achieve by working with as many businesses as possible. So it's really companies embracing technology, which is already available, because what we do is linked to open banking and open finance, and there is a lot of misconception that it's either it has failed or it is going to happen in the future. But the technology is here today, and actually it's extremely simple to implement it and fast. I mean, we've worked with customers where this has been set up within a month. I can explain, because I'm also on a stand here, so if anybody wants to hear our whole story with Voxia, Vodafone brand, literally within a month they were able to help their clients.
Excellent. Thank you very much, Ingrid. And Travers, for you, for Thought Machine, how does success look like?
So at one level, success is all of the banks understanding that this migration to next-generation cloud-native technology is an imperative. As Paul, our CEO, says in the film, if they don't, it will be very difficult for them. And that's a euphemism for they will fail eventually. The industry or the banks that do not make that transition to next-generation core banking systems, and notably, of course, ours, hopefully, will have long-term systemic problems within them. So at one level, it's kind of getting that message across very clearly that the technology within the banks is not sustainable. At a broader level, it powers a future state. So when we talk about things like, you know, next-generation products and services and the unique characteristics of financial inclusion, the unique characteristics around things like AI and so on, they all have to rely upon real-time systems operating at a kind of a personalization level that the traditional or legacy technologies cannot provide for. So it also proves for a future state of product and engagement. And if you like, our message is the transition point has to start now, and our expectation is that the film will support that message in market.
Excellent, and I hope they're listening very carefully. So Anil, what about you for Paysend? I mean, it's a fantastic video, it's very inspirational, there's a strong human element to it. What does success look like for Paysend?
Yeah, so for us, I think the main reason we wanted to kind of be part of the series was to raise awareness initially of the products that are available. And so through kind of demonstrating, you know, the human impacts on a personal level from the Libre product, we're able to kind of have an asset that we can then kind of use throughout Latin America and showcase the use case, because part of the problem is it's an awareness piece. It, you know, 70% of Latin American populations are either unbanked or underbanked, and that's an awareness piece. So once we've got an asset, which we have now, which is an amazing thing to use, we can then start kind of pushing that out and start to educate the populations on what's actually accessible to them. And I mean, ultimately, the end game for us is to include as many people as possible into the financial system.
Excellent. Thank you very much. So I'm hearing engagement, awareness. Helen, is that the same for you? Like, success for Unison is like spreading the word about Unison and also what good Unison is doing?
Definitely. I mean, if I can, I will answer to two parts. So at Unison, especially the marketing team, we've been very focused on customer acquisition. As a startup, we're very, very concerned about our budget and about, you know, what we do with the marketing budget and the overall organization budget to not only get our word out there, but making sure that we are evangelizing and introducing the concept to our homeowners. So my success has been customer acquisition, all the KPIs that you can imagine, right? So this piece is really extraordinary, and I think it's a very, I would say it's a leap of faith for us, because it's something that we have never done before. But when the BBC team reached out to us, we definitely saw the value and the opportunity for us to cast a broader net to introduce a concept, not only to our homeowners, but also, as I mentioned earlier, to our investors. So the the success will be measured with our earned growth, which is something that's new that we're embracing with our organization right now, which is based on, you know, word of mouth, the reputation of the company, but also the earned media that we may get from the piece. So really excited.
Great.
Thank you.
That's excellent. We're very excited to see the launch of these fantastic series, Wired Differently, Innovation in Finance. I'd like to thank our panelists today, Claire from the BBC, Ingrid, Moneyhub, Travers, Thought Machine, Anil, Paysend, and Ellen, Unison. Thank you so much for joining us today, and thank you very much for listening.